Hi everyone. We are talking about a topic which is intensely discussed in software engineering circles and interviews, which is, should you choose a monolith or should you choose a microservice? So monolith architectures are those which have huge systems. It's just one machine which is running the entire system. While microservices are these tiny, tiny dots where you just have one function running on one machine and they have tiny, tiny databases with each of them connected, interconnected, and you know, all the clients are connected to different microservices, while this monolith has all of the clients connected to the single machine, is what most people think. There's a common misconception that I'm trying to highlight here. The first one is that the monolith doesn't need to be single in terms of the number of machines you're running it on, because there might be multiple machines with the same monolith, and these clients can connect to them. They in turn can connect to this database or to more databases. So you can horizontally scale, you can scale out even with a monolith. There's nothing special about it. So the concept that a monolith is a huge machine which is running the entire system is not true. The second thing is microservices. There's nothing micro about a microservice. There's a microservice is a single business unit. All data, all functions which are relevant to a service are put into one service. If you can separate it, with a lot of concerns being separated out, then you probably want to separate a single service into pieces. So that's what a microservice is. It's not tiny machines which interact with each other all the time. There might be just three microservices in your entire architecture, depending on what your system is. And they themselves usually talk to their own dedicated databases. The client may not be talking to the microservice, it might be talking to a gateway. So these clients will be connected to the gateway, and this gateway is talking to these microservices internally. Now that we have some clarity on what microservices and monoliths are, let's understand what are the advantages and disadvantages of each architecture. Let's start with the monolith architecture. When put under a lot of load, the monolith architecture scales out, just like here, you have multiple servers. One of the key advantages of this architecture is when you have a small team, when you have a cohesive team and a small team, it doesn't, you know, you may not be able to afford the time and the interactions required to break this into a microservice. So if your team is cohesive, go for a monolith architecture. The second thing is there are lesser moving parts around this architecture. You don't need to wonder about how do I break this into pieces, and once they're broken into pieces, how do I actually maintain different servers at different times. So deployments in some way are easy because everything is the same. Thirdly, you might have some code which are for setting up tests, setting up connections, setting up various other things in your system. All that code need not be duplicated for every service that you create. It's all the same, it's all in one service. Fourth, this is faster because you're not making any calls over the network. It's not an RPC call, remote procedure. It's actually in the same box. So all that logic and all that code is in the same box, so it's going to run faster. You just need to make a local call. Now let's come to the fun bit, which is disadvantages. So the biggest disadvantage with this is if there's a new member in the team, they need to have a lot of context on what they're developing. If you give them a monolith, which contains all the logic, they have to go through and understand the whole system. So they have to put everything in their mind, in their context. The second thing is that deployments are complicated in this, because any change in the code, whether whatever part you're touching, requires a new deployment, your code is going to be deployed very frequently. And it has to be monitored every time it is deployed so that it's working properly. Even the tests are more complicated to write because everything is touching everything. It's not really decoupled as you would like. And the final point is there's too much responsibility on each server. If there's a mistake because of which the server crashes, all of these servers will crash and the whole system will collapse. Instead, if you had something which is serving profiles and something which is serving, let's say, some other data, maybe this could have connected to the profiles and this could have connected to data. This would have failed. This would have succeeded. You would have partial success in the system and you would just need to restart this point. Instead, you needed to restart all of them with the correct code. Now, coming to microservices, the most obvious advantage is that it's easier to scale. because you can look at this entire system as a suite, as a set of services, each concerned with only its data and interacting with each other. So it's easier to design the system in that way. The second thing is, whenever there's a new developer coming into the team, you can assign them a task which concerns with a particular service. So they just need to know the context of this service instead of the entire monolith. Right? We discussed this problem in the monolith too. The third point is that parallel development is easy because there is lesser dependency for the chat developers on the analytics developers now, because they can develop at the same time. In the monolith, maybe one function is calling the other function and it's changing. So there's a lot of coupling, tight coupling, not just in code, but also in the developer time. The final good point is that there are lesser parts which are hidden when you're actually deploying this service. If you're seeing there's a lot of load on the chat server, you can easily scale that out. You can put more machines for that chat code. With the monolith, it's more difficult to say what is being used a lot and what is being used less. So you're more likely to be putting in more servers just directly. Instead, here you can have a more streamlined approach for the problem. One of the things which are sort of a disadvantage of microservices is that they are not easy to design. So maybe the chat will be broken into far more parts which are not required. So a good indicator that you have a microservice which shouldn't be a microservice is that if it's talking only to one service. So if service one is just talking to service two all the time, that implies that maybe it should have been within a single service. And they could have converted this RPC to a normal call, a function call. That's the only disadvantage. It needs a smart architect to architect well for a microservice architecture. So in the argument of whether monoliths or microservices are better, what would happen in a system design interview is that you may need to justify why you're using a microservice architecture. 90% of the time, the system design interview is going to be on a large system. So for a larger system, a microservice architecture is more often than not better, right? So you're going to be going for the microservice architecture by default. If you're asked to justify this decision, then you should remember some of the points that we've discussed in this video, and then you can put them forward. Of course, if they're not good enough, then maybe they're giving you a hint that you should go for the monolith. There's a very successful system which uses the monolith architecture called Stack Overflow. I'm sure you've already heard of it. Microservices are used extensively in many, many companies like Google, Facebook, so on and so forth. So if you want to have an interesting discussion on what is better, you can have it in the comments below. I'll also be participating. And there's some relevant links in the description. If you want further notifications for videos like this, please subscribe. And if you liked it, hit the like button. I'll see you next time.